एंड सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग फाइव नॉलेज एरियाज फॉर प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट. द सिक्स्थ नॉलेज एरिया व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज प्रोजेक्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. आई थिंक दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एरिया फ्रॉम सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू बिकॉज यू पीपल आर फ्रॉम एचआर बैकग्राउंड, करेक्ट? सो यू माइट बी मोर इंटरेस्टेड टू नो दैट व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली द रोल ऑफ यू पीपल एज एचआर मैनेजर इन दिस प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट डोमेन. सो दिस प्रोजेक्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट नॉलेज एरिया इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नॉलेज एरिया फ्रॉम द पीपल हु आर हैविंग एचआर मैनेजमेंट एज देयर स्पेशलाइजेशन. सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली विल बी योर रोल, व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू डू. सो प्रोजेक्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इंक्लूड्स द प्रोसेसेस दैट ऑर्गेनाइज, मैनेज एंड लीड द प्रोजेक्ट टीम. सो एज वी आर नोइंग दैट एवरी प्रोजेक्ट विल बी एसोसिएटेड विथ अ टीम एंड दैट टीम विल बी कंप्राइज ऑफ variety of people. So organizing the team, managing the team and leading the team, that is nothing but all about the project human resource management. Now this project team will be comprised of people with assigned roles and responsibilities for completing the projects. So everybody who is inside the team, project team, will be assigned with certain kind of. Vaishnavi, are you able to hear properly? Okay. What about others? Am I audible clearly? Okay, good. So there will be you will be having a project team, and this project team will be comprised of many people. And all these people who are involved in your project team, they will be assigned with certain specific roles and responsibilities, which are directed towards achieving the goals, achieving the objectives of your project, or for completing the project successfully. So these project team members, they may be having variety of skills. They may be assigned to the team as a full-time member or part-time member. They may be added or removed from the team as the project progresses. So the project team, what we have, it may be having people who are having variety of skill sets. So some people will be from technical background, some people may be from management background, some people may be from software background, some people may be from marketing background, some people may be there from which will be from operations, some people will be there from design team. So variety of domains, variety of functions, variety of areas from which the people will be coming into the team as a team member. These team members, either they can be assigned as a full-time duty, full-time responsibility to work in this team, or they may be involved in multiple projects parallelly. So they may be working as a part-time team member for your project team. So few members will be full-time team members and few members will be part-time team members depending upon the work involved. Few people may be there for the entire project life cycle, and few people may be getting added or removed from the team as per the requirement of your project. So whenever their work is involved, the people will get associated with your team. Whenever the work is getting finished, those people will get removed from the particular team. So likewise, the project team should be looked into perspective that the people will be having variety of skill sets. They will be either full-time or part-time, or they will be with the team for entire project duration, or they may be with the team for limited amount of duration as per their requirement in the project. The processes which are involved in this project resource, human resource management are planning the HR management, acquiring the project team, developing the project team, and managing the project team. So exactly what activities we are going to follow, we are going to undertake in this project human resource management are you can see. First activity is plan human resource management. So in plan human resource management, we are going to have the processes for identifying and documenting the project roles and responsibilities, required skills, reporting relationships, and creating a staffing management plan. So in this particular case, when we are going to develop the human resource management plan, then we should be able to identify and document the roles and responsibilities of the people involved in your project team, which we should be able to identify the skills which are required for the people to join this team. We should also try to identify the reporting relationship, means who will be the people to whom the project team should report, and daily they should update about the progress of the project. So that should be also determined. Then we should be able to find out, we should be able to develop the staffing management plan. So these are some of the things which are required in the plan human resource management activity. Then the next activity which is there is nothing but it is acquiring the project team. When we say acquire the project team, it is the process of confirming human resource availability and obtaining the team necessary to complete the project activities. So we should the people who are responsible to have the HR management, they should go for acquiring the project team. They should invite the people from variety of domain, either from your own organization or some people outside the organization. Sometimes you will be having acquiring the people who are already working with your organization. Sometimes you will be altogether recruiting the people from market, especially for the concerned project. So likewise, variety of options are available to acquire the project team. This acquiring project team depends upon the required skill sets and the number of people responsible to be in the project team, etc. Then, next part is about developing the project team. It is a process of improving the competencies, team member interaction, and overall team environment to enhance the project performance. So once you acquire the team, the next thing what you should take into account is that team should be made suitable for completion of the particular project. We need to go for doing certain activities required for development of the project team. We should be able to improve the competencies and skills of the project team members. We should be able to develop the soft skills and interpersonal relationships of the team members, and we should be able to develop the overall team environment so that the people will be working to enhance the project performance. So that is about developing the project team, because simply acquiring the project team is not sufficient. We should try to develop it to make them suitable for carrying out the particular project. The next process is about managing the project team. So this managing project team involves the processes like tracking the project team members' performance, providing the feedback, resolving the issues, and managing changes to optimize the project performance. So you have prepared the human resource management plan, you have acquired the project team, you have started developing the project team so as to have them suitable for undertaking the project. Now the team has started performing. So their performance must be tracked, their performance must be evaluated. If their performance is excellent, then we should give them feedback that yes, you are performing excellent, and there has to be some appreciation. If the performance is below the required level of performance, then we should also provide the feedback, and we should encourage them to improve their performance. If there are certain issues with respect to the performance of the people, because of which they are performing below the expected level, then we should be able to resolve those issues, and we should be able to manage the changes so that the project performance will get optimized. So this is all about the project human resource management knowledge area. Next knowledge area is project communication management. So communication also plays a very, very important role as far as the project team or project is concerned. So this communication may be within the organization, we say intra-organization, or the communication may be inter-organization, that is outside the organization. The communication may be at the same level, that is horizontal communication, or the communication may be at the vertical level, that is top to bottom or bottom to top within the various levels. So these all sorts of communication, if they are managed properly, that communication will be playing very, very important role in your project. So this project communication management includes the processes which are required to ensure timely and appropriate planning, collection, creation, distribution, storage, retrieval, management, control, monitoring, and ultimate disposition of project information. In simple words, project communication management is all about the right information should be available to the right person at right time in right format. So that is all about project communication management. So what we say, the right information should be available to the right person at right time and in right format. If that is happening, then your project communication management is excellent. Similarly, the information which is confidential, it should not be available to the people who are not supposed to have that particular information. So which information should be available to which type of people in your project team or in your organization? So there has to be some proper methodology. There has to be some proper plan that which communication will be available to everyone, which communication will be available to limited people, which level of people will have what type of communication. So that plan, that entire planning is very, very essential. So that's why we have to plan this communication management. We have to manage the communications, and we have to also go for controlling the communications. So when we say the activity of plan communications management, it is a process of developing an appropriate approach and plan for project communications based on stakeholders' information needs and requirements and available organizational assets. So many people are involved with the project as their stakeholders. So each stakeholder has certain definite requirement and need from the particular project. So we should be having an appropriate plan to convey the appropriate information to the respective stakeholders as per their requirement, as per their needs. Okay. The next part is about managing the communication. The process of creating, collecting, distributing, storing, retrieving, and ultimate disposition of project information in accordance with the communications management plan. So in communication management plan, we'll be having the definite plan, definite strategy that which information should be available to what stakeholders or which stakeholders the information should be available. Now, once we know that a particular stakeholder needs a particular type of information, then how to create that information, how to collect the data, how it should be distributed, how the information will be stored, how the information will be retrieved from the storage, and how ultimately the project information will be disposed. That is all about the managing communications. Third activity in this communication management is about controlling the communications. It is the process of monitoring and controlling the communication throughout the entire project life cycle to ensure the information needs of project stakeholders are met. So this particular control communication process is spread across the project life cycle, and it is ensuring that the project stakeholders' requirements regarding the information which they are requiring, which they need, it is met, it is satisfied. So that is about the control communications part of your project communication management. The next knowledge area is one of the most important knowledge area of project management, and this knowledge area is about the project risk management. As we are knowing, risk is nothing but it is the threat to your project. It is something which is adverse to your project processes. So if these risks are not managed properly, if these risks are not responded properly, then those risks can become a threat to your project, and the project may go towards failure, or the project may not be successful. So this project risk management is one of the most critical area for project success. What it includes is, it includes the processes for conducting risk management planning, identification of the risk, analysis of the risks, then planning the responses to the identified risks, and controlling the risk on a particular project. The objective of project risk management are to increase the likelihood and impact of positive events and decrease the likelihood and impact of negative events in the project. So certain risks, they are having positive impact, certain risks, they are having negative impact. So the positive risks which are having positive impact, they are called as opportunities, and the risks which are having negative impacts, we call them as threats. So those which are having positive impacts, their chances should be increased, and those who are having negative impact, they should be decreased. Correct. So the various activities which are involved in this project risk management are planning the risk management, identifying the risks, performing qualitative risk analysis as well as quantitative risk analysis, then planning the risk responses, and finally controlling the risk. So let us see these project risk management processes one by one. The first and foremost is planning the risk management. It is a process of defining how to conduct the risk management activities for a project. So this plan risk management will be giving a detailed document about how this entire risk management process will be executed in the project. Second activity is about the identification of risks. Identify risk. It is a process of determining which risks may affect the project and documenting their characteristics. So in this identify risk, the people who are involved with the project, they will be trying to identify, predict the variety of risks which are possible for the project which is undertaken. And if that risk is happening, then what will be the probable effects of that risk on your project performance? What will be the characteristics of the risks? So all these things will be considered, will be discussed, will be documented in detail when we go for identification of risks. So there is a document created which is called as risk register, in which थ्रू ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग और थ्रू डिस्कशंस, थ्रू सर्टन फॉर्मल ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स, द पीपल विल बी डेवलप्ड, द पीपल विल बी ट्रेन्ड टू गो फॉर दिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द रिस्क. वंस दिस रिस्क आर आइडेंटिफाइड, आर डॉक्यूमेंटेड इन द रिस्क रजिस्टर, देन टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिस्क एनालिसिस दे आर कैरिड आउट. वन इज क्वालिटेटिव रिस्क एनालिसिस एंड अदर इज क्वांटिटेटिव रिस्क एनालिसिस. वेन वी गो फॉर क्वालिटेटिव रिस्क एनालिसिस, द रिस्क आर प्रायोरिटाइज, दे आर रैंक्ड, दे आर विच रिस्क रिस्क शुड बी गिवन मोर अटेंशन एंड विच रिस्क दे मे बी इग्नोर्ड और दे मे बी पेड लेस अटेंशन. दिस इज डिसाइडेड बाय यूजिंग वन पर्टिकुलर मेथडोलॉजी. दिस मेथडोलॉजी इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोबेबिलिटी वर्सेस इम्पैक्ट मैट्रिक्स. द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑकरेंस दैट इज पी एंड इम्पैक्ट दैट इज आई. सो द मैट्रिक्स इज कॉल्ड एज पी आई मैट्रिक्स वेयर वी हैव प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑकरेंस ऑन वाई एक्सिस एंड इम्पैक्ट ऑन एक्स एक्सिस और वाइस वर्सा, इम्पैक्ट ऑन वाई एक्सिस एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑकरेंस ऑन एक्स एक्सिस. एंड देन ईच रिस्क विल बी डील्ट विथ वॉट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑकरेंस एंड हाउ मच इज द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दैट रिस्क ऑन द प्रोजेक्ट परफॉर्मेंस इफ इट ऑकर्स. एंड द सीवियरिटी और द इफेक्ट ऑफ द रिस्क ऑन प्रोजेक्ट परफॉर्मेंस इट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय टेकिंग द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी वर्सेस अ प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड इम्पैक्ट. सो नेचुरली द रिस्क विच आर हैविंग हायर प्रोबेबिलिटी एज वेल एज हायर इम्पैक्ट, द प्रोडक्ट विल बी हैविंग लार्ज वैल्यू एंड दोज रिस्क दे विल बी मोस्ट सीवियर रिस्क फॉर द पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट एंड दे शुड बी पेड मोर अटेंशन एज कंपेयर टू द अदर रिस्क. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द क्वालिटेटिव रिस्क एनालिसिस. वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द जजमेंट रिलेटेड टू प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑकरेंस एंड द प्रोबेबल इम्पैक्ट ऑन योर प्रोजेक्ट एंड ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट द प्रायोरिटाइजिंग ऑफ द रिस्क कैटेगरीज. सेकेंडली द क्वांटिटेटिव रिस्क एनालिसिस इज बेस्ड अपॉन असाइनिंग सर्टन वेटेज टू द पर्टिकुलर रिस्क एंड न्यूमेरिकली एनालाइजिंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस रिस्क ऑन ओवरऑल प्रोजेक्ट परफॉर्मेंस. वंस वी हैव दिस एनालिसिस एंड वी कम टू नो दैट विच रिस्क दे शुड बी गिवन हाइएस्ट प्रायोरिटी फॉर रिस्पॉन्डिंग, देन वी शुड गो फॉर प्लानिंग द रिस्क रिस्पॉन्सेस फॉर ईच रिस्क कैटेगरी. इट मे बी हाईली प्रायोरिटाइज और इट मे बी ऑफ लो प्रायोरिटी. We need to find out the appropriate risk response strategy. So either the risk response may be in terms of mitigating the risk, or it may be in terms of avoiding the risk, or it may be in terms of transferring the risk, or it may be in terms of accepting the risk. Sometimes we need to accept because there is no other option. Sometimes we can transfer the risk to some other agency, to some contractor by using certain contract documents. Sometimes we can go for reducing the effect of the particular risk by doing certain measures. And sometimes we can go for avoiding the risk by just avoiding that particular work itself. So we need to have a proper risk response strategy plan. And that is nothing but this 11.5. That is plan the risk responses so that this is the process of developing options and actions to enhance the opportunities and reduce threats to the project objectives. And finally, the last process in project risk management is about controlling the risks. So the process of implementing risk response plans, tracking the identified risks, whether they are occurring or they are not occurring, monitoring the residual risks. So even after having the risk responses executed, still there may be some residual risks available. Identifying the new risks, because the risks which are identified at the initial phase of project, they are always there. But gradually when you go for executing the project, some risks may get added as a new risks category, a new risk category, because they were not identified earlier, but they will be the new risks available for the project because of the as and when you are executing the project. So those also you need to think in terms of how to respond them, and evaluating the risk process effectiveness throughout the project. So that is a very essential component of this control risk process, that we need to go for evaluate the risk process effectiveness, not only at a particular stage of project, but throughout the life cycle of your project. Next knowledge area is about project procurement management. As we know, procurement is nothing but related to purchasing or related to the, we can say, supply chain management, or making the resources available to the people at right time. So it includes the processes necessary to purchase or acquire the products, services or results needed from outside the project team. So whatever is needed by the project team to make the resources available, that is nothing but project procurement management. So when we say about the resources, it may be in terms of products, it may be in terms of services, or it may be in terms of certain results which are required by the project team. The organization can be either the buyer or seller of the products, services or results of a product. Okay. So the various activities which are to be conducted in the project procurement management are: planning the procurement management, conducting the procurements, controlling the procurements, and closing the procurements. So these are the activities which we are supposed to conduct in this project procurement management. So in planning procurement management, it is a process of documenting project procurement decisions, specifying the approach, and identifying the potential sellers. So we need to go for documentation of the procurement decisions. We should specify the approach of procurement, and we should be also able to identify who are the potential sellers for getting the required resources from the market for project. Then conducting the procurements. So we need to establish certain procedure for obtaining the seller responses, selecting the seller. So which criteria, which essential parameter should be checked when you are selecting a seller, and then finally how to award the contract. So what should be the contract documents, etc. That is nothing but conducting the procurements. Then controlling the procurements, it is a process of managing procurement relationship, monitoring contract performance, and making changes and corrections as appropriate. So once you start conducting the procurements, you have selected a seller, you have selected some vendor by carrying out some evaluation, and you have awarded contract to the particular vendor, to a particular organization, to supply certain material, to supply certain resources, then in the control procurement, we should go for managing this procurement relationship. So the relationship which are with respect to the sellers or the vendors or the suppliers, they should be maintained. We should also monitor the contract performance. So what are the terms and conditions mentioned in the contract, whether the agencies which have been appointed as the vendor, they are following the contract conditions or not, whether the contract is performing well or not. If not, we need to make certain changes and corrections as required in the contract conditions. And finally, closing the procurements. It is the final step of your project procurement management. So in this particular process, we have to complete each project procurement. So whatever agency you have appointed for supply of certain resources, supply of certain material, equipment,
machinery, certain services, certain consultancy, whatever. So those particular contract documents we need to check. Once you have received the resources in your as per your requirement, then you should be completing the remaining formalities. It may be with respect to the payments, it may be with respect to the certifications, it may be with respect to the testing reports, whatever. So those all things should be completed so that we can say formally the project procurement process is completed. And the last knowledge area is project stakeholder management. As we have discussed yesterday, this knowledge area was introduced in the project management body of knowledge in the year 2013 when the fifth edition was published. Before that, there were only nine knowledge areas. So after 2013, the knowledge areas got increased to 10 with the addition of this project stakeholder management. This knowledge area was introduced, it was included as an additional knowledge area because the people who were working in projects, they started understanding the importance of this stakeholder management and how the stakeholders are influencing the performance of the project. That was identified, and because of that, this project stakeholder management area was added. So this particular knowledge area includes the processes required to identify the people, groups, or organizations that could impact or be impacted by the project, to analyze the stakeholder expectations and their impact on the project, and to develop appropriate management strategies for effectively engaging stakeholders in project decisions and execution. So there are a variety of things which have been mentioned. So once we start thinking in terms of project stakeholder management, the first thing which comes in our mind is to whom we should call it as a stakeholder of the project. Whether the stakeholder should be some person, or the stakeholder should be certain agencies, certain organizations, or certain firms, or to whom we should say that these are the stakeholders of the project. So we need to identify first that who are the stakeholders. So who can be called as stakeholders? The stakeholders can be either certain people, they can be groups, means a group of people or groups of people. The stakeholders may be certain organizations which have impact or which are getting impacted by the project. So either these people, the groups of people, or the organizations, the agencies, they are impacting the project, or the project is impacting them. So if this is the situation, we say that these are the stakeholders of your project. Once you identify the stakeholders, the next thing is we need to identify their expectations and analyze them. What are the expectations of these stakeholders from the project? And we should also analyze what is the impact of their expectations on your project. Once you have this, who are the stakeholders? What are their expectations? What is the impact of their expectations on your project? Then we should develop the appropriate
हेलो
management strategies.
हेलो सर,
Hello? Yes? Sandesh?
हेलो सर,
हाँ, yes?
हाँ सर, हु आर द स्टेक होल्डर, जरा परत रिपीट सांगता का, माझा नेटवर्क गेला तो.
Okay, stakeholder is,
हु आर द स्टेक होल्डर्स, हे जरा परत रिपीट एक्सप्लेन करता का.
yes, we are discussing the same. Stakeholders are nothing but either they are some people, or they are group of people, or they are certain organizations or agencies or firms which are having impact on your project, or your project is impacting those people or group of people or those organizations. They all are called as the project stakeholders. Have you understood? Project stakeholders are either certain people or groups of people or some organizations which have impact on project or the project is impacting them.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, are
Yes,
they
sir.
directly connected to project or indirectly?
They may be directly connected to the project or they may be indirectly connected to the project. It is not like required that they should be directly connected. Like, let us say, I am telling in general terms, if we take our college as one organization and if we want to find out who are the stakeholders of an engineering institute or a management institute, then the stakeholders are nothing but first is the trust or the society management who has established this college. Then another stakeholders may be the people who are working in this particular organization. Then the next stakeholders may be the students. The another stakeholders may be the parents of their students. Whether the parents are directly related to the college? Are they directly related?
No.
No. But their ward, their children, they are studying in the college. These are stakeholders and the performance of their ward, their children, it is affecting their life. So that's why they are also stakeholders of the college. If the college is performing well, maybe their ward will get good placement and then their life will be settled. So the performance of the college is indirectly affecting the livelihood of the parents of the students. So that's why the parents are also stakeholders, or the parents are paying the fees, and parents' fees, they are nothing but driving force for college to run. So that's why the parents are also important stakeholders of any project. Similarly, the students who are passing out from the college, they are getting recruited by variety of agencies, variety of companies. So those companies who are employers, they are also important stakeholders of the college, because the performance of the college is indirectly affecting the performance of the company, because the students who are learning in the college, studying in the college, they will be the employees of that organization. If the college is good, the students will be good. If the students are good, they will be performing well. And if they are performing well, the organization will have more profits or it will be successful. So likewise, for any organization, for any project, either the people who are directly involved or indirectly involved, either they are having impact on the project or they are getting impacted by the project. So these all will be called as stakeholders of the project. I hope the point is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the first thing in this project stakeholder management is nothing but identify the stakeholders. The process of identifying the people, groups or organizations that could have impact or be impacted by any decision, any activity or outcome of the project, and also analyzing and documenting relevant information regarding what is their interest, how much is their involvement, what is the interdependencies of those people, processes, groups, organizations, what is the influence of them on the project or project's influence on their life, what is the potential impact on project success. So these all parameters we should consider when we go for this step, that is identify the stakeholders. Okay, so whatever we have discussed, it is the same that is coming in the step number one for project stakeholder management. Once you have the list of stakeholders, that these stakeholders have been identified, then we should go for planning the stakeholder management. That is the process of developing appropriate management strategies to effectively engage the stakeholders throughout the project life cycle based on the analysis of their needs, interest and potential impact on project success. So once we have the list of stakeholders and also we have understood what is their interest, how much they are impacting on the project success, how much the project is impacting on them,
what is their contribution in the project, whether they are directly connected or they are indirectly connected, then we should make certain plans to effectively engage them throughout the project life cycle, and this engagement will be based upon the analysis of their needs, interest, and their impact on project success. The next step is about managing the stakeholder engagement. It is the process of communicating and working with the stakeholders to meet their needs or expectations, address issues as they occur, and foster appropriate stakeholder engagement in project activities throughout the project life cycle. So when we go for managing the stakeholder engagement, we should have a proper communication with the stakeholders. For this communication, we should know what are their needs and expectations from the project and whether they are getting satisfied or not. We should address certain issues whenever they are occurring. We should go for improving, fostering appropriate stakeholder engagement in variety of project activities throughout the project life cycle. So we should know which stakeholder should get engaged at what particular stage of your project, whether they should be throughout the project life cycle, or some stakeholders may be for a particular process, some stakeholders may be for different processes. So as and when required, they should be engaged for the project life cycle. And finally, controlling the stakeholder engagement. It should not happen that unnecessarily the project stakeholders, they are making disturbances into your project performance. So we should monitor the engagement of the stakeholders, and they should be engaged for the proper duration, for the proper purpose, and we should have strategies and plans to engage the stakeholders at the appropriate phases, at the appropriate time. It should not happen that this stakeholder engagement becomes too large that the project team is not able to perform satisfactorily. So that care also we should take. And this is all about managing and controlling the stakeholder engagement.
Bahir alavar sagra sobat.